Hi everybody and welcome back to Tea Stains. Welcome back to another episode of Fallout 4. So it's a new day. What are you so protective of, Nick? We need to talk to Piper, I believe. Public address. She should be here, I think. Yeah, so today is Thursday. The Nintendo Switch comes out tomorrow. And I just recorded a little video. Talking about how I changed my mind and I'm not gonna record Breath of the Wild launch day. I'm gonna give it a little bit of time and watch that episode to see why.
Like acid rain down an old sewer.
You including your client here in that analogy? So, you two are finally letting me in on this little case of yours. What's the story?
We need help.
We need help, Piper. This man named Kellogg kidnapped my son. But that wasn't all. He was working with the Institute. He gave them Sean.
The Institute. Oh boy. I've been investigating these creeps for over a year now. The Commonwealth's boogeyman. Feared and hated by everyone.
True enough.
Sometimes they snatch people in the middle of the night. And sometimes they leave old synths behind to remind us that they're out there. But to this day, there's one thing nobody really knows.
Where the Institute actually is. Or how to get in.
Exactly. But there's one person who has to know, right? The guy who just handed them Sean.
Kellogg. Huh.
What about him?
He had to have a way in and out. But, well, we both know that angle is cut off.
A little bit.
Yeah. Any other ideas, Nick?
Talk about a literal dead end, huh?
So, a murderer and a kidnapper gets his brains blown out by an avenging parent. Huh. Be a great ending if we didn't still have the biggest mystery in the Commonwealth to solve.
I had no choice.
He wasn't gonna talk. Even if I had a way of bringing him in alive.
Gets his brains blown out. Huh. His brains. You know, we may not need the man at all.
You're talking crazy here, Nick. Got a fault in the old subroutines?
Look, there's a place in Good Neighbor called the Memory Den. Relive the past moments in your mind as clear as the day they happened. If anyone could get a dead brain to sing, it'll be Dr. Amari, the mind behind the memories.
Good idea.
I hope you're right, Nick.
Let's see. I guess we're gonna need a piece of Kellogg's brain. Enough gray matter to bring to Amari and find out if this is going to work.
Jesus, Nick! Gross! Seriously?
I know it's grisly, but what choice do we have? We got no leads, nothing. That old Merc's brain just might have all the secrets we need to know.
Actually, I think I already have something. Kellogg had this thing attached to his head.
Cybernetics, huh? We may have just won the lottery.
Whether we're riding this crazy brain train or not, we can all go running train across the Commonwealth. So, who's coming with you?
I have to go to the Memory Den either way, if I'm going to introduce you to Amari. If you want to head there together, just say so.
Take Nick.
It's you and me, Nick.
Let's get going. Don't worry. We're gonna get your boy back. Just a few more steps.
While you two are out, I'm gonna do some more research. I'll be here if you need me. And by the way, at some point, you owe me an interview. I want to hear how this whole story got started.
All right. Well, awesome. I can take that.
Well, so long as you're carrying it. Figure out a good use for it. Nothing stays hidden forever. At least, not if I have my say.
I'm gonna steal all of her shit now that I can.
Who do you think actually won the war? Nobody, I guess.
What? Why is there two doors? Don't give me these options. Okay, we'll go through this one. I get scared when there's options. That's how I function in life. Fuck, duck. I forgot to start
even
a timer.
Even good people do crazy things when they're scared.
Oh, pardon me, that was disgusting. Whoops! I forgot my timer running from last time I played. By the way, it's been 43 hours, 25 minutes, 58 seconds since I did it last. Okay, Jesus, I already forgot what I was doing, but I remember now. It's okay, everything... Oh, man, I got the burps. I had an energy drink now for the first time in, like, weeks. Woo. Wee! I've been trying to quit them nasty things. Ooh. Things are acting weird. Oh, there we go. Wee! Cool. Pit Boy. I want a model of a Pit Boy. I know a lot of people have them. They're super cool. Oop. Okay. Was there anywhere we can fast travel to first? Park Street Station? Good neighbor? Ah. Oh. Yeah. Cool. Before the war, Vault-Tec began construction of Vault 114 inside Boston Street Station. The project was never completed, but that matters little to gangsters who have taken up the residence there. Yeah, I know. I've already been there. I want, like, a company to actually make, like, a fallout shelter. And, like, I'm not talking, you know, like a fallout shelter, like one in your basement, like on that move, multiple movies. But the one movie I'm thinking of with, I think it had Brendan Fraser. Not a clue what it was called. That's the only one that comes to mind right now. I think that'd be cool, though, right? Okay, good news is that bad. Probably should have waited till daytime. Oh. Okay, well, I got four left. Should be okay for right now. Part of me's like, maybe we'll go this way. Part of me's like, maybe I should just, like, drop off the armor somewhere. Part of me's like, dude, just keep it. It's fine. Oh, fuck, the entrance is over there. Yeah. Okay. I heard a super mutant trying to talk to me.
I hear something.
I don't. Where even is it? It's fine, we're good. We're in the clear. Let's go. There we go. That wasn't that hard, right? Free your mind. Whoa. I think it's Nita. I love the art design for Fallout. It's like futuristic, but like, you know, not. If that makes any sense.
Well, it's the detective tracking down another wayward husband to his mistress.
Why? Someone stand you up?
You trying that, what do you call it? Evasive language on me? And who are you, huh? Valentine's new dick in training?
We're working together,
yeah.
Really? Well, you're in luck. I got a special offer on some insurance for partners of the Great Gumshoe here.
Sure. Insurance?
That's right. Insurance. Personal protection, like. You hand over everything you got in their pockets, or accidents start happening to you. Big, bloody accidents.
Nick Valentine makes a rare visit to town, and you're hassling his friend here with that extortion crap? Good to see you again, Nick.
Hancock?
What do you care? He ain't one of us.
No love for your mayor, Finn? I said let him go.
You soft, Hancock. You keep letting outsiders walk all over us. One day, there'll be a new mayor.
Come on, man. This is me we're talking about. Let me tell you something.
Oh!
Now, why'd you have to go and say that, huh? Breaking my heart over here. You all right, brother?
Hello. Yep, I'm fine.
Thanks for taking care of him.
Good. Now don't let this incident taint your view of our little community. Good neighbors of the people, for the people. You feel me? Everyone's welcome.
Okay.
Good neighbor? That what you call this place?
That's right. We cobbled this little neighborhood together out of the freaks and misfits that just wouldn't be accepted anywhere else. You'll see. You make enough friends here, you'll call this place home soon enough. So long as you remember who's in charge.
Okay, good to know. Got that, Nick? Alright, let's go. Here we go.
A new player in good neighbor. Hello, little pawn. Welcome to our fun and games.
You look like a man. Oh, hey.
Well, hello. Everything here is guaranteed to injure, maim, or kill at your discretion. Except me. I only kill when I want to.
Oh my. What are you?
What are you?
I'm a woman, baby. Can't you tell?
Nope. Yep.
You certainly look like a woman, yes.
Then that's all that matters, right? Now are you buying what I'm selling?
Murder.
Let's see what you got.
Purchase a variety in case of boredom.
What do I want? Well, I really like some fusion set. Ooh, fusion cores. It's almost all the money I have. No thanks. That's so expensive. Whoops. Alright, never mind. I feel like I do need to buy ammo, but ammo's so expensive. Sometimes it's just easier to go in with next to no ammo and like, get all yours on site. Which is what I think I'm gonna do. Memory den, right there. You know what? I'm gonna go in and then just drop my power armor. Because I don't wanna keep wasting batteries. Yes. Oh no, I might be burdened. Yeah.
Shit.
By how much? Ooh, quite a bit. Nick isn't here. I should just grab my power armor. I'm gonna go to the store and dump it and try to sell it all. Now the question is, do I want to turn around and get back in the power armor, or just hobble there? We're gonna hobble there.
Now I know you all are doing your own thing, but I don't want anyone here to forget what matters.
Oh, hey.
Hey, Daisy, glad you could make it. How's my favorite? Didn't I see you on the Rowski the other day?
Huh, he wishes.
I noticed.
All right, getting off track. What was I saying? Oh, that's right. What
silent during
we freaks gotta stick together. And the best way to stick together is to keep an eye out for what drives us apart. You feel me?
Yeah, you tell it like it is, Hancock!
Now, what out there in our big, friendly commonwealth would want to drive us apart? What kind of twisted, unneighborly boogeyman would want to hurt our peaceful community?
The Institute and their synths!
That's right. Who said that? Coming up to my office later, you've earned yourself some jet. The Institute. They're the real enemy. Not the Raiders. Not the super mutants. Not even those tools over in Diamond City.
I don't know, Hancock. I'd sure love to give McDonough a kick in the ass.
Hey, we all know I got my own personal beef with that lard head. But stay focused. Now, I want everyone to keep the Institute in mind. When someone starts acting funny. When people are doing things they don't normally do. When family starts pushing you away for no reason. We all know who's behind that kind of shit. And the only way to stop it is to stick together. They can't control us if we're not afraid. Now, who's scared of the Institute?
Not us!
And which town in the Commonwealth should the Institute not fuck with?
Good neighbor! Good neighbor.
And who's in charge of good neighbor?
Hancock!
Of the people!
The people! For the people! For the people!
Brotherhood of Steel is nothing then. We come in peace.
This is one of the few places in the Commonwealth that accepts ghouls. Not like those bigots in Diamond City.
I really should have grabbed power armor. Okay. Damn it, I was hoping I could talk to her through the window. There we go. Let's go. Hello.
Hey, Cleo.
I've got a weapon here for every situation.
Right, I'll take a look. Sure.
Murder and me.
Okay. My inventory. Let's go weapons. I got a bunch that I do not need. Ooh. When did I get that baby? I like it. How do I enter? Yeah, I can sell that. Fat man? No, we need to keep that thing. Yeah, I'm gonna sell the mines. Glacier light pipe. Yeah, get rid of that. Institute pistol. I don't want to keep that. Minigun? Should probably keep that. Molotov. Machete? It's good for when I run out of ammo. Pipe bolt action? Yeah, that thing was. That thing's hard to deal with. Pulse grenade? That's a lot of sniper rifle. I should keep that. I love that thing. Revolver, rifle, submachine gun. It's one of the only that I have that takes 45s, isn't it? Oh no. Oh no. I'm reading the wrong thing. Okay. Sure, we'll keep that tire iron. Oh. Okay. Apparel. Yeah, we'll sell Kellogg's outfit. Sell that. No, we should keep all that. Miss junk. Part of me doesn't want to get rid of any of this. It'll have very little weight. Yeah, not too worried. Ammo, keep. Okay. So, let's see how much weight that maybe lose. Nice, under, okay. Now all the junk I have can go to the sanctuary. Because that can be used for building stuff, so. I'll make sure to do that. Okay.
Well, well, Mr. Valentine.
Hello, miss.
I thought you had forgotten about little old me.
May have you? Walked out of the den, Irma, but I'd never walk out on you.
Amari's downstairs, you big flirt.
Downstairs we go. Ooh, what's in here? Anything I can steal? Nah, super shitty stuff. Makeshift batteries.
Dr. Amari?
Yes, I take it this isn't a social call.
Hello.
You're the one who can extract memories from a brain, right?
Normally, we only allow our clients to experience their own memories. Now, what's this all about?
We need a deep dig, Amari, but it's not going to be easy. The perp, Kellogg, is already cold on the floor.
Are you too mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to defile a corpse, you don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brains to function.
Please. Nick told me you're the only one who can make this work.
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Institute, Amari. The biggest scientific secret of the Commonwealth. You need this, and so do we.
Fine. I'll take a look. But no guarantees. Do you have it with you?
There you go.
Here's what I could find.
What's this? This isn't a brain. This is... Wait, that's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it? A neural interface?
Those circuits look awfully familiar.
I'm not surprised. From what I've seen, all Institute technology has a similar architecture.
Go on,
Doctor.
Mr. Valentine is an older generation synth. But Institute technology being what it is, the brain implant could fit him.
Oh, Jesus.
An incredible risk to take. We're talking about wiring something to his brain.
Don't worry about me, Amari. I'm well past the warranty date anyway.
You really think this will work, Nick?
No idea. But we got a missing kid on the line. That's worth the risk.
Whenever you're ready, Mr. Valentine.
You're a good dude, Nick.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Let's see here. I need you to keep talking to me, Mr. Valentine. Any slight change in your cognitive functions could be dire. Are you feeling any different?
There's a lot of flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, Doc.
That's what I was afraid of. The mnemonic impressions are encoded. It appears the Institute has one last failsafe. There's a lock on the memories in the implant.
Well, now what? Ready,
break? Tell me you have a way past this, Doc.
Let me think. The encryption is too strong for a single mind. But what if we use two? We load both you and Mr. Valentine into the memory loungers. Run your cognitive functions in parallel. He'll act as a host, while your consciousness drives through whatever memories we can find.
Any idea what I'm going to see in there?
I have no clue. But considering we only have a single piece of the medial temporal lobe and not the whole brain, I doubt it'll be cohesive.
Let's do it.
All right. Let's get started.
Just sit down over there and keep your fingers crossed.
All righty.
On the other side.
Good luck, Nick. Jesus, this would be scary. Oh, hey, cool. It's the loading thing. Can't look around.
Initiating brainwave migration between the transplant and the host. Mnemonic activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on.
White. White balance on this camera is terrible. That's what I get for using a webcam.
Can you hear me?
I can.
Oh, good. The simulation appears to be working, although the memories are quite fragmented. I'll try to step you through the intact memories.
Some VR shit.
And hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location.
Oh, I can walk. Whoa.
There. This is the earliest intact memory I can find.
Okay, I can walk on this. Can I fall off? No. Okay. Jesus. Hello.
Remember, you are experiencing these memories as Kellogg.
Whoa.
This may prove disorienting at first.
All five states have now signed on.
Hey,
this moment, we are all citizens of the new California Republic. I'm sure that's going to take some getting used to for a lot of people.
What a joke. What's it mean, Mom? Nothing, Connie. People like to talk and hope someone else is going to keep them safe. Teacher at school said the NCR would bring back the good old days. Like before the big war. Don't you listen to that twaddle. I'm going to stop sending you if that's what they're teaching you.
I'm going out. Where the fuck did you put my boots?
Listen to
me. Dad was either drunk
or
not around. I guess he must have run with one of the raider gangs, but I never really knew what he did. Don't know why Mom was with him. Maybe at some point in his life he wasn't a complete asshole.
You take this. You're old enough. You're the man of the family now. It's your job to protect us. Your father's useless, but you won't turn out like him. You're a good boy. And all that on the radio, all useless talk. The only thing that will protect you in this world is that gun in your hands. You need to learn to use it if you're going to survive.
I will, Mom. I promise. I won't let you down.
You've always been my good boy.
Jeez. This doesn't seem to be what we're looking for.
It's sad.
There appears to be another intact memory close to you in temporal sequence. There. Try that one.
Okay, well, I'm gonna talk to everybody this time. Me.
The thing about happiness is, you only know you had it when it's gone.
Sarah.
I mean, you may think to yourself that you're happy, but, you don't really believe it.
Harry.
Focus on the petty bullshit or next job or whatever. It's only looking back, by comparison with what comes after, that you really understand that's what happiness felt like. I was the worst thing that ever happened to her. If she'd never met me, she'd have stayed in the hub, maybe hooked up with someone who didn't kill people for a living. Probably been happier than she was with me. Almost certainly lived longer. I thought San Francisco was my chance to start fresh. I was the hot shit, the gunslinger from the hub, rolling into town with the world at my feet. Everybody knew I was the one who'd shot Valdez. I could ride my own ticket to any outfit in town. It all worked out pretty damn well. For a while.
And who's Mary?
Whatever made me think that a guy like me should have a daughter? No, I never deserved her. Not for one second. It's gonna be fine. You'll see.
But we don't know anybody here. And now, with the baby?
Come on, Sarah. You've got to give it a chance. I finally got steady work with a good outfit. Nothing like that in the NCR these days.
No, I'm not saying this was a mistake. I'm just... Are you sure these guys know what they're doing? They seem kind of green.
I know. But that's where I come in. Just wait. In a few years, I'll be running my own crew. As soon as I make the connections I need. Then I can give you anything you want. And little Mary, too.
I never worried about you before. Must be my mama instincts kicking in. Who knew I had those, huh?
Come on, you're great with her. And you don't need to worry about me. Most of it's just running security for the Shi. A lot of standing around looking tough.
Well, they sure picked the right person for that job.
Listen, it's gonna be great here. See this? This is what's gonna keep you and Mary safe. I promise.
Woof.
I know, Connie. I'm sure we're gonna be really happy here.
We are. You'll see. That's okay. I got her.
Let's keep looking. I'll connect you to the next intact memory.
Oof. Super weird.
How did you think this was gonna end, Kellogg? You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with you? Just so you know, they died like dogs. And you...
I found another memory.
...weren't there to help them.
They're talking about his family. That's really sad. This is still really weird, by the way. I'm gonna keep bringing it up.
Mind if we sit down?
Suit yourself. I didn't care where I was going. Ended up mostly wandering east. Getting as far away from San Francisco as I could, maybe. I don't remember much from that time. It all kind of blends together. There was almost always a bar, though. That's universal.
So, I hear you'll take care of people's problems. Is that right?
If you pay me.
Oh, we'll pay you. And, you'll do this all by yourself?
That's right.
We pay you when the job's done. Is that okay?
That's the way you want to do it. So who do you want dead?
Well, it's like this. There's his family. Lives down the creek a ways.
Well, we seem to be getting closer. Try this next one.
Those must have been the people he was talking to who got him the job to grab Sean. So those guys must be actually working for the Institute, not really wastelanders. Maybe. I just guess.
Mr. Kellogg, I'm glad you decided to meet with me.
So, you're with the Institute. I wanted to see for myself if you really existed.
We do, as you can see.
What do you want?
It's come to my attention that you've been rather disruptive of our operations lately. This must stop.
I do what people pay me to do. If that's a problem for you, I can see only one way out.
And what's that, Mr. Kellogg?
If I'm working for you, there's no more problem. From what I hear, you can afford me.
I don't think you fully understand the situation you're in.
I think I do.
Very well. B-748, initiate.
I finally ended up in the Commonwealth. I kinda ran out of road. Plus, I'd come to terms with life.
Around, he is.
I wasn't gonna be stupid enough to get mixed up with caring about other people again. It was just me against the world.
Yeah. They're looking around. It's
and
gross.
The world had it coming. You heard all sorts of rumors about the Institute. But I figured they were just a convenient boogeyman for anything bad that ever happened. They were real, all right. They didn't know anything about operating on the surface. Relied on their synths for everything. They had the resources I needed. And I had the expertise they needed. It turned into a permanent arrangement. Which suited me just fine.
Impressive. We may have something to talk about after all.
Getting warmer. One of these has got to tell us something. We're running out of brain here. There's one that looks mostly intact. Connecting now.
Might be the last one. Oh.
Manual override initiated. Cryogenic stasis suspended.
Both computers are still working. That's good. Checking for
all lives.
Hopefully it's all
just find it.
Pod C6, down the hall near the end.
Backup subject, me.
Even then, I knew it was a mistake leaving him alive. I understood that kind of revenge. No one better. But I was cocky enough to assume I could handle some soft, pre-war vault dweller. Even if he somehow got thawed out. At least I...
Oops.
I never knew why we didn't just refreeze the rest of them. But we had our orders. Guess the old man didn't want so many loose ends. Too bad he left alive the one person he shouldn't have. I was now the Institute's main operator in the Commonwealth.
Oof, look at you go.
If they needed something done, it came to me. It wasn't usual for anybody from the Institute to come along on a mission, so this one stood out. I didn't know then who it was we were grabbing from the vault. Of course, neither did they. Not really. The eggheads never liked taking orders from a dirty, contaminated degenerate like me. But they needed me. And I made sure they knew it.
Go for it. Right here. Oh, there we go.
I'm glad I didn't have to kill the kid. I'm not saying I haven't done it, but I never liked to. And yeah, I guess it did remind me of her. Yeah, I'm a cold-hearted bastard for sure, but still human. Better this way, though. Better than taking her kid and leaving her alive.
This is better for this guy, though.
Here.
Open it.
Is it over? Are we okay?
Almost. Everything's going to be fine.
Come here. Come here, baby.
No, no. I've got him.
Let the boy go. I'm only gonna tell you once.
I'm not giving you Sean!
Oh. God damn.
So brutal.
Get the kid out of here and let's go. Please, we still have the backup.
Cryogenic sequence reinitialized.
What's the holdup? I'm almost finished, Kellogg. I just need to confirm. Come on. All right, we're good.
I'm sorry you had to go through that again. I found another intact memory.
Oh.
Whenever you're ready.
There's no running in this part.
Whoa, is that Sean. Your son? This appears
wasn't
to
my
be
idea
very
to settle
memory.
Down with the kid in the middle of Diamond
it means,
City.
I
thought it was a terrible idea, actually. But it was one of the old man's pet projects, so here we were. Me and the kid. Like a happy little family. I ended up kind of liking it. A reminder of what my life might have been if things had turned out differently. But there's no going back. I knew it was just temporary. It'd be back to normal business before too long. This whole setup in Diamond City was part of some elaborate plan of the old man's. Seems obvious now that we were bait for our friend from the vault. Timing couldn't have been an accident. It's not how the old man works. I wonder if he outsmarted me in the end. Another loose end tied up.
Oh boy. Piper's really done it this time. I mean, I'm not saying she's right, but Mayor,
now what?
Kellogg.
Whoa.
It's okay. One of these days, you're gonna get your head blown off just barging in here like that.
Minimizing my exposure to civilians is a priority.
Forget I said anything.
Or
the
sir.
New breed of synths could easily pass as human. Some of them did. But the coursers, they weren't built to blend in. They were killing machines. Pure and simple. Smarter. Stronger and faster than almost any real human. I'm just glad they were always on my side.
No doubt.
So what's the big crisis this time?
New orders for you. One of our scientists has left the Institute.
Left? As in?
He's gone rogue. Name's Dr. Brian Virgil. We know he's hiding somewhere in the glowing sea. Here's his file.
Oh, goody.
Wow. Some heads are gonna roll for this. Capture and return, or just elimination?
Elimination. He was working on a highly classified program.
No kidding. One of the top bioscience boys? Damn. So, I guess you're taking the kid back with you.
Affirmative. Your only mission is to locate and eliminate Virgil.
You're taking me home to my father?
Yes. Stand next to me and hold still.
Okay.
I didn't think Sean looked brown. Whoa, what is up with his face? Something wrong with the lighting.
X688, ready to relay with Sean.
Bye, Mr. Kellogg. I hope
his
I see you.
Neck is all white.
Bye.
Teleportation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute because there is no entrance. Let me pull you out of there as soon as you're ready.
Yank me out. Ooh, give me. That was sad.
Slow movements, okay? I don't know what kind of side effects the procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before. How do you feel?
Am I okay? Are you seeing anything bad?
Don't be alarmed. But I honestly don't know what to look for. As I said before, this is uncharted territory, but your neural and physiological readings have returned to normal. From a medical standpoint, you're fine. Are you ready to talk about what happened in there?
We got what we needed. The Institute uses teleportation to get in and out.
Yes. Their greatest secret has finally been revealed. But that only leads to more questions. How does it work? Where do we go next?
Virgil. That scientist Kellogg was supposed to track down. Virgil, we need to find him.
You're right. A rogue Institute scientist could answer all kinds of questions. Where did the memory say he was? The glowing sea? That doesn't make sense. No one goes there. Not even if they were desperate.
Perfect.
That's why he's there. To make the Institute think twice about following him.
That must be it. He's using the radiation in the glowing sea like a shield, or a cloak, a way to throw them off and be at an advantage. If Virgil found a way to survive there, you'll have to do the same. If you're going to follow him.
I got one.
I'll find a way to get through the rads. Don't worry.
Good luck, and be safe. By the way, I unplugged Mr. Valentine first. Remove the implant while you were waking up. He's waiting for you upstairs.
Okay. Thank you, Doctor. Yay, I can take these without her saying anything. Oh, that last one was stealing. See, they turn red for a half second after you take them.
Ooh. Hell yeah.
Includes Grognak of Bavarian holotape. Did it give me anything? Free holotape for this issue. Oh, it's a holotape game. Gotcha.
Take. Not enough folks value keeping the old CPU shut.
Doop, doop, doop. Purified water. Nice. Wonder glue. Oh, wait, wait. Fresh. Use all I can. Nice, nice. Don't mind me robbing you blind, Jack. Sweet. Okay. Bye! Thanks for letting me take all your shit. This. Ooh. Oh, I to steal. Yeah.
The memory den's not accepting new clients right now, sweetheart.
I just came from there. What the hell? Oh, there he is. Hey, Nick.
Hey, Valentine.
Hope you got what you were looking for inside my head. That was right. I should have killed you when you were on ice.
What?
Kellogg? Is that you?
What? What are you talking about?
You sounded like Kellogg just then.
Did I? Huh. Mari said there might be some mnemonic impressions left over. Anyway, I feel fine, so let's get going.
Jesus. I want to take
you. Let's get going, Nick.
Been one heck of a ride so far. Let's see where it takes us next.
Well, it says his relationship went up, so I want to see what
listening.
It says.
Nick.
What do you need?
I wanted to make sure things were okay between you and me.
I've been thinking about that myself. I suppose we're okay. I feel like we could be doing more for folks out here, but otherwise, we're all right.
Okay.
Your thoughts?
You good to keep going? I don't sleep or eat or anything like that. But if you need to, you do it.
Oh, nothing.
Sure, sure.
Let's go. Trusty old power armor. Oh, there we go. Okay. Awesome. Boink. Okay, so I got 4 fusion cores, which should be enough to get me there with the power armor. Should, at least. Okay. Let's look at our map. Where do we gotta go? I think it's... Yeah, it's down there. Where are we going to see? Diamond City looks like it's gonna be our closest. You know what? Let's go to Sanctuary first. I'll drop off all my stuff. And then... We'll, go to Diamond City and walk to the... To the... Glowing Sea next. That's a new unique facial tattoo. Huh. I love that picture. Big, meaty, beefy guy crying
perfect,
like a girl.
But we're surviving.
Yeah?
Okay. Transfer. Store all junk. Ah, that's a bunch of weight off.
Nice job with those defenses.
Thanks.
I've got nothing else I need right now. I think Preston may want to chat, though.
Yeah, Preston can wait. I want to put this baby up and see if I can mod some stuff. Transfer? Oh no, that's not what I want. Let's just hop out. Can't exit arm here. Over here. There you go. Okay. Transfer. Take all the things. Let's craft. Okay. Ooh, I can do a Model B. Improves damage. Well, actually, let's do torso first. Model A, Model B. What are you? Oh. Model B. Okay. Wait. Damage and energy resistance. All over. Material mod. Military paint. Oh. Increases charisma. Okay. Risk mod. Stealth boy. Oh, cool. Well, can't do any missed mods. Okay, let's go helmet next. Headlamp. I do that. Model A, Model B. Cool. Tear it. Oh. Ultimate. Yeah. Let's do it. Left arm. Model B. Oh, I need aluminum. Exit. Okay, well, let's see. Oh, fuck. No. Damn it. Let's put in our half-used one. But now let's transfer. Let's see if we can find some aluminum around here.
Find what you're looking for. I know it.
E. Tab. No. T. Damn it. I don't remember. Workshop. Okay. Scrap. Steel. Quite what I need. Steel cloth. Lamp. Steel, 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 and everything is made out of steel apparently in these days. No aluminum. Okay. More steel, damn. With a bathtub. Ceramic steel, fuck. I think there should be some aluminum somewhere, right? What the fuck's made of aluminum? You probably are. Can't scrap you, though. Weird. Crouch is making... Or... The... Shift is making me... Stop. Steel. Yep. Damn it. Yeah, 10 steel. More steel. Fuck. And I wonder why they were having terrible shortages on, you know, everything vital. As explained in the beginning backstory. Fucking plastic. God damn it. Dockhouse. Should have guessed that. I don't know why that. I thought that would be made of steel. Or aluminum. Lamp. Steel, rubber, fuse, broken. God damn it. Still not what I want. Ooh, hey, I do need to cook some stuff though. Can't scrap that, apparently. Nope. Steel, fuck. Gear spring wood. Thermometer. I don't want to keep that. Trash can. Fuck! Hello, Preston. It took me a second. I was like, who the fuck? Can't scrap any of that. Yay. Branch. Well, I might be shit out of luck. Like, I don't even know what the fuck would be aluminum. Everything looks like it would be, but I feel like that's all modern day things that would be now. Steel. 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 Plastic, glass, rubber, would. Nope. I still feel bad scrapping his Sean stuff. Even though it's been like 200 years. Well, I might just have to give up and say what I got is good. Still fucking... Still, like, I have no clue why the bloody... Oh, hello. Escape. Oh, god damn it. What was it? No, I don't want to do that. I don't know. E. Oh, no, already did that one. V. Aha! That was it. Scrap. Fuck. This light does help, actually. 20 wood. God damn it. Okay. I'm giving up. Just gonna recycle that though, because ceramic is useful. I dropped something. Scissors. Yay. Can't grab the scissors? Alright. Okay. Well, fuck it then. I guess I'll just have to find some aluminum elsewhere.
You ask me, freedom's always worth fighting for.
Because you're part of the, you know, whatever. Whoa! Cap stash!
You building a collection or something?
Yeah, something like that. How the hell didn't I notice that cap stash before? Well then. I'm just gonna transfer that last little bit of junk I grabbed though.
Huh? Speak up.
Oh, hush it. Spoil all junk. There's nothing else I can do on this thing, eh? I just want to double check before I go off of my gurney. I mean journey. Left arm. A. B. Nope. Imperial mod. Nope. Over to Misc mod. Oh, come on. Nope. Leg. All right. Oh yeah, I should probably repair some of these, eh? T. Okay. T. Lost steel. Cool. At least everything's repaired. Transfer. Okay, let's hop on in. And let's quick travel to the Iamon City. Oh, good. Radstag. A deer. Oh, it's got like two sets of front legs too. Gross. Okay, well, we will start our journey to what the fuck that is. Start our journey to the Glowing Sea on the next episode of T-Saints. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.